From Chicago Stadium, along with Steve Jones and Rick Barry, this is Bob Neal. Just moments before the American Airlines Sheraton long-distance shootout, the competitors today are Danny Ainge from Boston, Larry Bird from the Celtics, Dale Ellis from Seattle, Craig Hodges of Milwaukee, Mark Price, the second-year youngster from Cleveland, Detlef Schrempf from Dallas, the man who took Bird to the finals last year, Byron Scott from the L.A. Lakers, and Trent Tucker, who's the career three-point leading shooter in the NBA. And they are not competing against each other, which I think is something for everybody to remember, Steve, and that is that what they'll do, that all eight will shoot in the first round, of course, and we're looking for the top four scores. The maximum, there are five racks of balls, 25 balls. The maximum number of balls that can, points that can be scored are 30. So the top score, and a good score would be 16, 18, something of that number. A good score, and then we will list the top four scores. They'll advance to the next round. And you saw the money, the championship will be worth $12,500. The American Airlines Sheraton long-distance shootout rules are relatively simple. The competitors attempt to score from behind the three-point line. It's longest distance, 23 feet 9 inches. Shortest in the corners, 22 feet. They'll have exactly 1 minute. And remember, I will remind you of this, each round is scored separately. The baskets made from each round do not carry over. There are five balls in each rack, four brown balls worth 1 point, one red, white, and blue advantage ball worth 2 points. If tied, the players would compete in a 24-second shootout. And that's the basic rules, not much more to it. And gentlemen, Steve and Rick, talk a little bit about these locations and what some of the strategy we might be seeing today.
Well, I'll take the corners. I think that those are the places where they can really make their biggest dividends. If they can get the balls to go in from the corners, they have a better chance to really get a big score.
Here's Danny Ainge from Boston. He's 6'5". He made 23 consecutive games of three-pointers on a pace to set records for most three-pointers made and attempted in the season.
Well, you can see Danny, he likes that side shot, but again, Danny really is quite a jump shooter. He uses his legs a great deal, and that could prove to be detrimental to him in this competition.
And Dale Ellis, he's blossomed into one of the NBA's leading scorers last year. He averaged nearly 25 points a game, won the most improved award. Dale Ellis.
Well, I think Dale Ellis, of all the players in this, wants to prove that he belongs in the All-Star game. He's had a tremendous season so far. He has the ability to strike from long distance, but he, like Ainge, is a jump shooter as well.
And Craig Hodges from Milwaukee was the runner-up in the inaugural American Airlines long-distance shootout 2 years ago, won the NBA three-point title in 86 on the final day of the season.
Well, he also, again, purely a jump shooter, and he had like 25 points in the competition 2 years ago, but it seems like he runs out of gas the longer the competition goes because he uses his legs so much.
And here's a youngster who played his college basketball at Georgia Tech. He's become one of the NBA's most dangerous long-distance shooters, shooting at right near 60% from three-point line.
Well, that makes it easy to say he's my guy. I'll go out on the limb and I'll take the young guy, Mark Price, but he's a jump shooter as well. He likes to get the ball in a rhythm, so it'll be interesting to see how he goes.
Last year's runner-up, when his final shot bounced off the rim, 6'10 forward from Dallas, this is Detlef Schrempf.
And he's the fellow that I think still has the chance to upset Larry Bird. He came very close last year when he did miss that last shot, as you pointed out. But as you can see, he's more of a set shooter. He really doesn't use his legs as much. He can get into a rhythm, shoots the ball more like Larry Bird. And I would say that he would have to be seated number two right behind Larry.
And Byron Scott's enjoying his finest pro season in the backcourt for Los Angeles this year. It's a five-year veteran, NBA's three-point leader in 85, and he's a good one from long range.
Well, the key for Scott, I think, are the corners. He loves to shoot the ball down in the corner, and if he can get a good stroke going from there, I think he might surprise and score well.
And just like you saw there, as you see Trent Tucker, if he can shoot the set shot, which he can do, he's got a good chance.
Trent Tucker is a six-year pro. He leads all active players in career three-point accuracy.
Well, I think Trent Tucker, he's a street shooter and one of the best, and if he gets a stroke going, he'll be dangerous early, but again, he has a tendency to run out of gas.
And the man, two-time defending champion in the shootout, who sank 11 shots in a row in a stretch in the finals 2 years ago. Last year made eight in a row to defeat Detlef Schrempf.
Well, Larry Bird is, again, the man to do it all. He has such great confidence, and I think the biggest advantage he has, Steve, is the fact that he believes he's going to win every time he steps out there.
Yeah, now, he tells all the other guys that, too.
Larry Bird and Danny Ainge have been talking about All-Star Weekend, this three-point competition, and the All-Star Game tomorrow for the past month on the Celtics. That's a kind of a no-holds-barred New York rules, ribbing each other kind of ball club, and the two of them have really set themselves up for today's competition. Now, the players had a drawing to determine the order of the shooting today, and it came out this way. Danny Ainge will go first, followed by Trent Tucker, Craig Hodges, Mark Price, Byron Scott, Dale Ellis, Larry Bird, and Detlef Schrempf. So Danny Ainge is going to begin here. He ranks third in active players in career three-point shooting with a 576 mark. And the thing I think that has really made this thing very interesting is that Danny Ainge has attempted more shots than a lot of teams this year. And two players are going at the same time. On the other end is Trent Tucker. On the left will be Ainge, and we'll be following Ainge with on the left side here, and Trent Tucker will be on the right side. Steve, you keep a check on Ainge.
Well, Danny Ainge just got his money ball to go in.
Same with Tucker. Trent is going more for the set shot. He's not shooting the jump shot, trying to save his leg. He just knocked another one in.
Well, so did Ainge, and he got another money ball, but that was a good rack for Danny Ainge.
Now, remember, the brown ball's worth 1 point each. You got to shoot all of them before you shoot the two-point red, white, and blue ball. Exactly 30 seconds left. Ainge is ahead by three baskets at this point.
Well, Tucker's struggling here, and, of course, you want to get the highest point total. They're not against one another. Tucker's starting to find the range right now, two in a row. Three.
Ainge is still competitive.
Tucker got four out of five with the money ball the last rack.
They're tied at 10 with 8 seconds remaining.
Tucker missed all but one in the last rack.
And Ainge got the money ball.
Ainge finishes with 13 points and Trent Tucker with 11. Now remember, this is not head-to-head competition. The top four scores of the first round will advance to the semifinals. So Trent Tucker with 11.
And remember, last year, 13, they had a playoff to see who made the fourth spot. Larry Bird was involved in that and won the shoot-off to make it into the next round.
Well, those are both pretty good scores for the guys that started, and that's going to put some pressure on Mark Price
and Craig Hodges.
Mark Price will be, as we look at them from our courtside seat, on the left, and Hodges will be on the right. They have 1 minute. There are 25 balls to shoot, a total of 30 points, and Steve Jones is going to keep track of Mark Price, and Rick will be watching Craig Hodges.
And Mark Price.
By the way, as you watch these fellas underway, Ainge has been credited officially with 14 points, and we'll do more about that later.
Well, Price got two of the balls in his first rack, including the money ball, and now he's on a stroke.
Hodges only got one, the money ball, and finally hit the second one. Craig definitely struggling here, Steve.
Well, speed and accuracy is important, and Price is doing just that from right in the middle of the court.
Exactly 28 seconds left. Both players have a little more than two racks left.
Well, Hodges made a ball, but he was on the line and disallowed it. He had another one taken away, Hodges.
Tough night for Hodges against Price, who's shooting extremely well now.
Price has 11 now, Hodges 7. 10 seconds.
Rack hurt Price if he doesn't get the money ball.
Hodges didn't get all the shots off because of the jump shot. Plus, he had three baskets made, taken away because he was on the line.
So unofficially now, Price with 14, Hodges with 10. Ainge also had 14, so that means Ainge and Price both have 14. Tucker with 11, Hodges 10. The top four will advance. And now the official score for Hodges is 9 points.
Hodges looks like a fighter, and they're taking everything away from him.
Well, you can see how hard he's breathing. When you shoot the jump shot, it's going to be the case. It takes more effort.
And the next two competitors will be Dale Ellis, number three from Seattle, against Byron Scott, who wears number four from the Los Angeles Lakers.
Ellis is ready, and he really wants to do well tonight.
Remember, Ainge and Price both have 14
now,
points.
Byron Scott,
Tucker with Dale 10 Ellis. And Hodges with 9.
Byron going to the set shot, not using the legs, has knocked three in a row in.
Ellis has got two and the money ball.
Five in a row for, six in a row now for Byron Scott.
He had seven before he missed.
And Ellis is shooting the ball well, and the crowd has gotten behind him now.
30 seconds remaining. Scott with 10 points, 11, and Ellis with 7.
And he's got four more in a row, and counting the money ball, he's shooting the set shot, and he's got it going for him.
Ellis gets the money ball, so he's still in the hunt on points.
Got one in the next to the last rack.
Scott with 14, Ellis with 12.
Ellis with three, four in a row. The fourth one popped out.
10 seconds remaining. Two more in a row for Scott. Three in a row. He likes that corner spin. You pointed it out. And the money ball. The advantage ball hits.
Well, both of these young men had a very good round. Scott finishes with 19, Ellis with 15. And right now, out of six competitors, the top four will be Scott, Ellis, Ainge, and Price, as of now.
And the heat is on.
And Dale Ellis didn't get all his balls up.
And the final two competitors will be Larry Bird and Detlef Schrempf, who were the finals last year. And let's take a look at Scott here.
And Scott finishing off as he knocks another one in. You see him shooting the set shot, not the jumper. He's going to have plenty of legs left. He's going to be very tough in this competition using this style. There he goes, knocking him down, and the advantage ball for 2 points. And he's got the high point total and a lot of pressure on these two fellas now.
They've got to get at least 15 to get in.
14 for a shoot-off.
So Scott has 19 points, Ellis 16, Ainge and Price 14 each.
Larry
Bird and Schrempf.
Well, Bird, he likes that corner, and we'll see how he goes.
Schrempf, two in a row. Three in a row.
Bird just made one, now he's even at two in that first round.
Schrempf hit four of the five, counting the advantage ball.
Remember now, Bird had to get into a three-way shootout, a 24-second shootout last year, to advance. He starts very slowly, and the key to beating Bird is beating him here in the first round.
Well, Schrempf is hot.
Well, Schrempf is hot. They both start on the same side. They can't see each other, but Bird just got the money ball in.
And Schrempf hit four to five again.
We have 20 seconds remaining. Detlef Schrempf with 13 points. Bird with only 10, now 11.
That's a big one for Bird. He got the money ball.
And Schrempf had a bad rack. He's next to the last rack. He needs some here.
They're tied.
Bird just moved ahead.
5 seconds left.
Schrempf ties him.
Bird hits the big two-pointer for 17 points. Schrempf will finish with 15 points. So the top scorers are Scott, Bird with 17, Ellis with 16, and with 15 points, Detlef Schrempf.
And
unofficially, those are the top four.
Knocked out Price and Ainge. That was some clutch shooting by both players. The last four players came through.
They really shot the ball well at the end. Schrempf can't believe he didn't get that one.
So that was the finish of round one. Now let's just double check again. We have Scott with 19, Bird 17, Ellis 16, Schrempf with 15 to advance as we look at Schrempf on his first round competition.
See, he's basically a set shooter. He jumps a little bit more than Larry, but he got it going there on the middle rack, as you can see him dropping him in.
Advancing to the semi.
So Larry Bird this year, last year had to go into a 24-second shootout. This year, he finishes second among the eight to advance.
Well, I think Bird was thinking on that last rack, just make sure I get a couple of round balls in and then finish with that money ball, and he did.
All right, we'll be back with the semifinals. It will be Scott, Bird, Ellis, and Schrempf when we return to Chicago Stadium.
This ESPN Classic presentation is brought to you by Ford F-Series. The best-selling trucks are built Ford tough.
Everything was going well on Frank's first night as foreman until he made one tiny mistake.
There's a Ford F-Series in the lot with the lights on. There's a Ford F-Series with the lights on.
F-Series is America's best-built, best-selling truck. It's 50 years tough. And obviously, for a lot of people, it's the only truck that's tough enough.
Next time, Frank, get the plate number. Ford F-Series, the biggest, toughest trucks ever built Ford tough.
My job is to compare products. And it's not often that I'm surprised. So when Head & Shoulders went up against the leading prescription brand, I expected the prescription to be better. But it isn't. A study proves Head & Shoulders is effective against dandruff. I found out there's a microscopic fungus associated with dandruff, and Head & Shoulders helps kill it. Help stop flakes before they even start. Not even the expensive prescription works better. You may never see flakes again. I don't.
There's a new choice when you have the flu. Introducing Tylenol Flu Nighttime. For relief of your worst nighttime flu symptoms. And unlike that other flu medicine, it contains no alcohol. New Tylenol Flu Nighttime. It's all the relief you need.
Andrea Stinson is very emotional. She's a leader of her team.
Cheryl and myself are like two different players. She's a much more of a shooter from the outside. I'm much more of a give me the ball and run to the other end.
Being bigger, being taller, she's more physical.
Andrea Stinson with a spectacular play.
Just playing against this great competition.
She's another one of those players that I'd much rather have on my team.
Everybody join in.
You're watching the Michael Jordan Celebration on ESPN Classic.
So this will be the order of competition here for the finalist. We will have the first shooter is Detlef Schrempf, who will go first. Schrempf, Bird, Ellis, Scott all made it, with the eliminated players being Ainge, Price, Tucker, and Hodges. So Detlef Schrempf, who took Larry Bird to the finals last year. The rules are the same in this round as in the round of eight, except the players will shoot one at a time. 1 minute, 25 balls, a maximum of 30 points.
Now Schrempf, who got off to a great start the last time, is struggling in that first round.
Looks like he's got a little too much legs. He's going a little long on a lot of his shots, Steve.
Well, I think Schrempf is more subject to the psychological pressure than anybody else, but he's got it going now.
That last one didn't count. He was on the line, so he only has one, and he's going to be in big trouble. I think there's no way for him to make it into the finals.
In regular season play this year, Schrempf hitting only 3 of 18 for 17% as of the 1st of January, so he has been struggling all year.
And he's struggling right now. As I said, his chances, unless he knocks all of these balls in, or the majority of them, are almost impossible to make it.
Now he needs a big finish. He was jumping up and down, hoping he'd get that money ball in. He just got 5 points.
And we have 3 seconds left, and Schrempf has had a nightmare. Detlef Schrempf unofficially with only 5 points. That'll almost certainly eliminate Detlef Schrempf unless everybody else goes ice cold. Remember, the scores from the first round do not carry over. Individual scores in each round here. Can you see if anything's wrong with his form or anything, Rick?
Well, I don't think it's so much the form as it is just the fact that he got off to a bad start and he fits a little bit of pressure trying to make all of the balls at this point.
Looks like he's shooting the ball a little bit off to the left side. That one that he knocked in, the last one didn't even count because it was after the buzzer. A lot of his shots were a little bit left. He may have had his hands at the right of center of the ball, but he definitely did not have the groove going that time.
Next. Now Larry Bird is the next competitor in this semifinal round. Bird shooting 39% in game three-pointers on the year. He has 1 minute, 25 balls.
It's always nice to hit the first one, but Larry not being able to get in the groove yet.
Got the big two-point ball, however, at the end.
Well, this is your guy, Rick, and he's always been able to perform well under pressure, and he usually picks up steam with deep rack.
Well, there's two in a row, three in a row. Let's see how many he can come up with. Four.
Including the two-pointer, 8 points for Bird now.
He's got it.
30 seconds left on the 60-second shot clock.
Yeah, he's got the rhythm going right now.
And Bird's got 13 points with 20 seconds remaining.
Well, he's not getting to the racks too quickly, but he's able to get a lot of shots out of him very fast.
That's because of the groove he gets in that set shot. He doesn't waste a lot of effort.
18 points for Bird, 8 seconds left.
19 and counting, make it 20.
And he gets the two-pointer. Unofficially, 23 points for Larry Bird. That's only 2 points short of the record 25. The maximum you can get is 30 if you hit every shot. So the hired assassin with the sharp eye is firing it on target today.
You see Larry finishing off. Look at at that smooth rhythm. The shot, one step back, pick it up, the shot. Back and forth. He is like a machine, and the results are almost like a machine. He's really got it down to a science.
Larry Bird, the leader. We're in the semifinal round of the American Airlines Sheraton Long Distance Shootout from Chicago Stadium, along with Rick Barry and Steve Jones. This is Bob Neal, and we're going to have Dale Ellis coming to the line now. Dale Ellis, who had 16 points on his first attempt, had been slumping a little bit earlier in the year in long-range shooting, but comes into this competition hitting 42% in game action.
Ellis is real strong from the corners, and he just got the first one to go. Let's see if he picks it up as he moves around.
Only one out of the first rack. That's not good for Dale. But watch the difference in the style. He has so much more motion in his shot compared to Larry Bird, because he takes more of a jump shot.
But he got a good stroke. He got 4 out of 5 balls in that rack.
Now we have 34 seconds left. Ellis with 7. Eight points now. He's 2 racks left with 21 seconds.
He just needs to try and make as many as he can here down the end to put some pressure on Byron Scott, because Shrimp is out of the competition right now.
Shrimp had only 5 points. It's the big two-pointer. That's 12 points for Ellis. 7 seconds left.
See if he gets through all the balls. This is where he didn't finish the last time.
Let's see if he gets this one off. He does not. So Dale Ellis unofficially finishes with 12 points. Bird had 23, Ellis 12, Shrimp 5, and now the final competitor will be coming up. That'll be Byron Scott.
Great concentration by Dale Ellis, but again, he took just a little bit too much time. It may hurt him. Now, when Byron Scott goes, because he has such a great start, I think he might feel a little bit more pressure than everybody else.
Well, Byron is a clutch performer, and I like the way he's shooting. We talked yesterday, and I said, Byron, if you're going to have a chance, shoot the set shot. He said, really? I said, definitely, save your legs. And that's what he elected to do here, and he knocked him down in the first time.
All right, we have Byron Scott from the Los Angeles Lakers. He has a minute of clock time. He's got to get better than 12 to finish second.
Got 3 on that first rack, so he's off to a pretty good start.
Well, Scott has his most trouble right out here from the side, so he's got to get some business done in this rack and the one from the middle.
Got the big two-pointer right there with 35 seconds. Scott has 7 points.
Got 9.
He needs to beat 12. 24 seconds for Scott. He has 9.
Plenty of time left. He just needs to get it to drop in. A couple more.
Now, the shot seems to be flattening out right now, and all he's getting is the front rim.
This would give him 11. 10 seconds.
He needs 2 more.
He's not going to get it.
Byron Scott unofficially has 12 points. And that 12 would tie him with Ellis for the semifinals and mean there would be a 24-second shootout.
And I'll tell you, if that happens, Larry Bird definitely is going to be the big favorite, because 20 more seconds of shooting can really hurt them. You see the slow motion shot of Byron Scott. Good form, nice follow through, good rotation on it, and he's able to knock that one in. No, he got the bad bounce on that one.
Now we have Scott officially with only 11 points as they checked it. It is 11 for Scott. So the winner is going to be, the two finalists will be Larry Bird and Dale Ellis. There will be no shootout. And they are going to the middle of the arena for a coin toss. So Byron Scott, officially with 11, is eliminated.
You see Byron shaking his head. He really had it locked up. He had 2 racks to go, only needed to knock in 3 balls out of 10, and wasn't able to do it.
Well, that rack on this side there in that deep position, all of his balls kind of flattened out. They hit the front rim, and that really put the pressure on him. And here comes Bird back in a familiar position. So let's see if anybody can upset the world, and that means Dale Ellis.
You're watching the Michael Jordan Celebration on ESPN Classic.
This ESPN Classic presentation is brought to you by Burger King, where you can have the delicious King of Fries. Burger King, when you have it your way, it just tastes better.
Loving you is more than just a dream come true. And everything that I do is out of loving you. And every time that we
when you have it your way, it just tastes better.
It knows two speeds. Stop and go. It just beat a series of the toughest stop-and-go driving tests in the world, and it's brand new. Go ahead. Guess.
Guess.
You have 4.3 seconds. Introducing Pennzoil with new Pure Base. Stop. Go. Pennzoil.
Foot pain got you down again? Introducing Therasoles Plus, the revolutionary Far Eastern shoe insoles that combine magnetic pressure point therapy with the arthritic healing power of copper. Therasoles Plus are the solution to tired, aching feet and so much more. The secret of Therasoles Plus are these specially designed magnetic discs, pressure points, and copper elements that make them so much better than ordinary insoles. Here's how they work. When you stand or walk, the pressure points stimulate the nerve endings in your feet that correlate to all parts of your body. At the same time, the magnetic discs help support good blood circulation, while the copper elements help relieve pain caused by tendonitis and arthritis. That's why Therasoles Plus help relieve daily aches and pains in your feet, legs, knees, back, and neck, reduce stress, and give you a remarkable boost in energy.
Magnetic pressure point therapy has been used in the Far East for several centuries. Now you can experience the same amazing benefits with Therasoles.
The average person takes over 10,000 steps a day. And with Therasoles Plus, every step you take will stimulate and relax your feet while providing your entire body with the benefits of a soothing and energizing massage. Therasoles Plus are the solution to get you back in the game. They fit easily into virtually any shoe, conform to any size foot, and they're perfect for men and women of every age. And now this incredible breakthrough in well-being can be yours through this special television offer for only $19.95. But hold on, we're so sure you'll love your Therasoles Plus, we'll let you take them for an incredible 60-day test drive. If you're not more energized, simply send them back for a full refund. But wait, if you call within the next 10 minutes, we'll double your order absolutely free. That's right, you get two pairs of Therasoles Plus for just $19.95. Call now.
To order your Therasoles Plus and receive a second pair absolutely free, have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-524-2700. Remember to specify men's or women's insoles. Or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $4.95 shipping to the address on your screen. For quicker service, call 1-800-524-2700.
Check out the ESPN Classic website at www.classicsports.com for listings, stories, and the chance to tell us what you want to see on ESPN Classic.
Larry Bird, there's his uniform right there, number 33. Larry and the three-point shot came into the NBA at the same time. Now, at first, this is hard to believe, Bird didn't like the idea of shooting from so far out. And he thought he'd, you know, never use a shot. Of course, once he did, he became one of the best at it. But he thought that the three-pointer should be used only in certain game situations. For instance, when the Celtics were on the road and they were up by about five with time running out, Larry would try to sink a three-pointer to make the lead go up to 8 points and just bury the other team. He called it a knife in the heart, the killer shot. And with that kind of confidence, it's no wonder that when Larry would come into the locker room before the All-Star three-point contest, he'd say to the other players, "So, who's going to take second? Psych." Now, let's return to Chicago Stadium, where Larry Legend faces off against Seattle's Dale Ellis in the final round of the long-distance shootout here on Classic Sports Network.
Let me explain the coin toss here. They'll toss the coin, and the winner of the coin toss can elect to shoot first or second. The loser will then have his choice of baskets.
Looks like Dale won the toss, Bob, and is deciding what he wants to do.
Same, I will receive.
Dale Ellis won the toss, and he can choose to go first, and he has said he will go first, and Bird chose the end opposite to the direction they are walking for his shooting.
Well, he's been wearing this end out.
We'll be back in a moment for the finals.
Dale Ellis, we are not going to go away. Dale Ellis is going to shoot right now. 1 minute, 25 balls, a maximum of 30 points. The winner with $12,500. Second place, $7,500.
This first rack is probably the most crucial for Ellis. If he can get a good rhythm going, he'll have a chance.
Well, he's got it going, like you said, Steve, four in a row.
And you know, I might mention here, he may have launched that first ball before the siren sounded, and we'll make sure to see if that, in fact, is an official point.
Well, Ellis is a player that, you know, can feel a little bit of pressure, but he's got some good results in the first two racks.
Now we have 30 seconds remaining, and Ellis with 9 points, and 11 with the two-point ball.
Let's see if he even gets all the balls up this time. He has yet to do that. Well, this rack has hurt him, Steve.
Got a big ball there. Now he's got to really go with some speed and accuracy from the corner.
10 seconds left, 14 points for Ellis. He gets them all off. Unofficially, Ellis with 15, but we're going to hold just a second to make sure of that. The first shot may not have counted. And Larry Bird, the two-time defending champion, nobody has ever defeated him in the long-distance shootout, is set to go right after we take a look at Dale Ellis.
There you see Dale firing away. He got off to a terrific start, like you said, Steve, and I thought that that would get him going. However, even though he shot well on the second rack, the third and fourth racks were really his downfall. He was only able to drop that one brown ball and 1 2-point shot in on those two racks, and that could prove to be very costly going up against the defending champion, Larry Bird.
You know how Bird is. He feels that when the money's down, no one is better than himself.
Yeah, watched him. He lined all those balls up to be in the perfect position on that first rack. I'm surprised he didn't do it on all of them.
He has 60 seconds, 25 balls. He has to beat 15 points, a slow start.
But he warms up as he gets going.
3 points out of the first rack.
Well, he's all over the place in this rack. Usually he comes back with that big money ball that keeps him close.
He's hit both the money balls, both the two-point balls.
It's like he's over-adjusting. He's come up short, and then he all of a sudden throws it a little bit long. He certainly doesn't have that normal Bird rhythm going for himself.
He does not. At 25 seconds remaining, has only 7, has to be 15.
That's 8. Make it 9. And 10. At 11, as we're counting. 13.
Huge rack that time for Bird.
He's still got to drop one here quickly. 14. This is a tie for the money.
Yo! Larry Bird at the buzzer with the two-point ball. 17-15 defends the long-distance shootout crowd at Chicago Stadium.
Our winner is Larry Bird. Every fan in this section received the McDonald's PR gift card. Good for a free breakfast on a plate.
Ice water in his veins.
The man is really spectacular. He was all over the place, as Steve pointed out, in the first three racks, and when it came down to the money time, this is what the man responded to. He needed to make a couple down the stretch. He needed to make the last three to win, and he's down to the last three. There's one. Now he's tied, and now he's the winner. Three times in a row.
He knew it when he let it go and was headed for that check in the winner's circle. Bird came through with the big, big shot.
All right, we're going to come back and have the trophy presentation and an interview with Larry Bird, who has won all three of the long-distance shootout. They're going to handicap this guy next year. We'll be right back to Chicago Stadium.
You're watching the Michael Jordan Celebration on ESPN Classic. This ESPN Classic presentation is brought to you by Coca-Cola Classic. Always the real thing, always Coca-Cola.
Okay. Dandruff, psoriasis, scalp dermatitis. If you ask all the dermatologists listed here to recommend a therapeutic shampoo, Neutrogena T-Gel would come out number one. T-Gel works on all three itchy, flaky scalp conditions. Neutrogena T-Gel, it works.
Did you know you can get a six-cylinder Nissan Frontier for less than the cost of a four-cylinder Tacoma? Think about it. That's like getting 170 horsepower but only paying for 150. Or like getting 2.5 tons of towing capacity but only paying for a ton and three quarters. Amazing how they do that. The V6 Nissan Frontier. Ranked best compact pickup in initial quality by J.D. Power and Associates.
Join in and log on to WNBA.com and reach every team and every player. Check out WNBA news and notes. Get interactive with contests and polls. Or shop at the WNBA store. Go courtside every game from live box scores, real-time shot charts, in-game video highlights, and live audio broadcasts. Be a part of the fun and go one-on-one with your favorite WNBA stars. Connect with the game. WNBA.com.
This is ESPN Classic.
Here's the presentation of the trophy. Wonder when they retire it, how many will win. Who will be the next great outside shooter? Now let's go out to the middle of the floor following the trophy presentation and Craig Sig.
Thank you very much, Bob. I guess it was no surprise, but the dramatic way in which you won it this third time is amazing. What were you thinking after the terrible start on that final round?
Well, I just worried about getting the two-point balls down after I missed the shots. But, I knew he just had 15 points, and I had still had plenty of time. Once I got to the top of key, I knew I had to make some shots.
Those first two racks, the ball was all over the place. How did you get your rhythm back?
Well, you have to concentrate a little bit more and take your time. Minutes a long time to get up 25 shots, so I just took my time and was just hoping that some of them would start dropping for me.
With names like Al Capone and John Dillinger, Chicago's had some memorable shootouts. Maybe not stakes this hot, but nobody cooler under pressure. You really thrive in this.
Well, it's a lot of fun. You know, the guys come out, and it's a little bit harder than it looks. I got out there, and I knew I had to beat 15 points. I just took my time and made some shots at the end, and everything worked out for me.
Congratulations once again.
Thank you.
Larry Bird winning the long-distance shootout for the third year in a row. And if you thought that was exciting, stay tuned because we have the Gatorade Slam Dunk Championship next on All-Star Saturday.
You're watching the Michael Jordan Celebration on ESPN Classic. This ESPN Classic presentation is brought to you by Subaru. Hungry for adventure? Take a taste test in a new all-wheel drive Subaru today.
Some folks think my Subaru Outback here is just for exotic adventures. Truth is, it's good for the everyday stuff, too. You know, like running down to the store, picking up the mail. The secret, full-time all-wheel drive. Something you just won't find in a Cherokee or a Blazer. Comes in handy when you say, late for a hair appointment.
Right with you, mate.
Now you know why I wear a hat.
We're going all the way. Nothing's stopping us. It's high ground by nightfall.
Go! Go!
Critics are calling the thin red line powerful, outstanding, and astounding.
I want you to attack. I want you to attack right now.
An instant war film classic. Two thumbs up. Visions you'll never be able to shake.
What difference do you think you can make one single man in all this madness?
The Thin Red Line. Rated R. Now playing only in theaters.
You have 4.3 seconds.
Introducing Pennzoil with new Pure Base. Stop. Go. Pennzoil.
This is ESPN Classic.
All right, the Slam Dunk Championship coming up next. Of course, we have three of the champions from the four Slam Dunk competitions here at Chicago Stadium today. We will have Spud Webb, who won in 1986, Dominique Wilkins, who won in 1985, and the 1987 defending champion, Michael Jordan. And Larry Bird just won for the third time in as many years, the three-point long-distance American Airlines Sheraton long-distance shootout, 17-15. And once again, Larry Bird, it doesn't seem to matter who the competitors are. Whoever Bird has to face in the end, if he has to hit the big shot, he hits the big shot. This time it was Dale Ellis, who finished second. By the way, Ellis will get $7,500. Byron Scott finished third. He'll get $5,500. And Detlef Trimpe will get $2,500 for finishing fourth.
Well, it's still not a bad day's work. But again, I think what Bird demonstrated is ability to make the big shot when it means something. He's done that continuously throughout his career. This is just a way to magnify his ability.
And now in his own town, Chicago, Michael Jordan here to defend the 1987 Slam Dunk Championship he won. And we have an announcement for you. We have just learned that Ron Harper of Cleveland, the youngster in his second year in the NBA, who was scheduled to play, cannot play because of a foot injury. We understand from the NBA folks, so there will be seven in the Slam Dunk Championship instead of eight because Ron Harper, with a foot injury, has elected not to make that injury worse by competing in the Slam Dunk Championship.